of our own immigration crisis.
Mm-hmm.
All right. A lot of talk has been made in behalf of the political discussion now for Trump and otherwise, and he really opened up a lot of the doors for this. What do you think the answer is? Is it actually going to be solved in the near future, or is it just a continuing growing problem? Larry.
It depends on who gets elected. If a Democrat gets elected, no. If a Republican gets elected, I think something may very well happen. What Donald Trump has done is to make an issue that neither side really wanted to talk about, an issue that's central to the campaign. And so now you're having candidates, at least on the Republican side, saying we need to secure the borders. They would not be talking about it if it hadn't been for Donald Trump. There's also a lot more information now about the economic damage and the crime damage being done by illegal aliens. So I believe something is going to be done if a Republican gets elected. I think the borders are going to be secured. There's going to be some sort of way of tracking down the overstayers, because that's 40% of the way people come into the country illegally. I think something will be done about sanctuary cities. Something will be done about catch and release if there is a Republican president. If not, and it depends on the Republican also, I think Marco Rubio is squishy on the issue. I think Ben is right. He was one of the gang of eight willing to do some sort of compromise, reform on immigration, and it's a real problem. I don't know if you saw Stephen Colbert interview Ted Cruz. It was really quite interesting. He said, Ronald Reagan, your icon, did two things. He raised taxes. He also signed an amnesty bill. And normally Ted Cruz is very sure-footed and bright, and I thought he was going to, it was a home run right over the plate. I thought he was going to say, well, I'm happy you brought those up, because Ronald Reagan lived to regret the tax deal, because he was promised for every dollar in taxes there'd be $3 in cuts. Got the taxes, didn't get the cuts. So that's a bad example. If anything, it represents you ought not trust your side. The other thing about the immigration amnesty deal that Reagan signed is he was promised two things. He was promised that going forward, employers who knowingly hired illegal aliens would be sanctioned and the borders would be secured. Neither was done. So I think if a Republican comes in other than Marco Rubio, something will in fact be done.
Excellent. What about you, Ben?
I'm skeptical that anything will be done, because I think that there's a significant wing of the Republican Party that doesn't want anything done too. I think the Democrats clearly don't want anything done, because they both get to use it as a political football and also import an entire new voter base, because eventually a lot of these people do end up becoming citizens, or they don't even have to. Their kids become citizens automatically as soon as they're born here and then they vote. And that's, I mean, this is the reason why you have seen Democrats winning for the last 40 years in this country on a more and more consistent basis, because of the demographic shift. If we had the same demographics in terms of income and background that we did in the 60s, then Republicans would basically win every election. That has nothing to do with natural that has nothing to do with the connection between ethnicity and politics. It has everything to do with the fact that the country also at the same time decided they were going to just import people who were poor, and we weren't going to do anything to actually integrate them into Americanism or assimilate them. I think there are a lot of Republicans who don't want the issue solved, because the issue is beneficial for even a side of the Republican Party. Wedges in the Republican, what people don't understand, I think, and they need to understand about the Republican Party, is the Republican Party is just a vehicle. If the Republican Party that hires up in the Republican Party, imagine if the government were as small as it were back in 1840, for a second. If the government were really that small, how many of you would give to either party politically? The answer is none of you would give to any of these political parties, because you'd have better things to do with your money. If the government is a major issue in your lives, well, that's how a lot of people in the Republican Party pay their bills. And that's true for a lot of the consultants, and it's true for people like me and Larry. It's true for, you know, it's true for a lot of folks. The bigger these issues are, and this includes for a lot of Republicans, the more money gets spent on those issues. And I think that there are a lot of people in the Republican consultant class and a lot of people in big business who look for the government to give handouts. And mm-hmm. I wish it were as simple as my side were always right, their side is always wrong. Unfortunately, even within our side, on the conservative side, there's some people who I don't think... Well, yeah. Are fully honest on
real quickly, but I think it's changing, Ben. I'll tell you why. I've got a friend named Peter Kersenow. Despite his Russian-sounding last name, he happens to be black. He's on the U.S. Civil Rights Commission and did a study on illegal immigration and found out, I think probably the leading economist on this issue is a guy named George Borjas. He's at Harvard. And he said that illegal immigration has caused X percentage of loss in jobs, X percentage of loss in income for inner-city workers, the ones that are unskilled. He sent all this data to Marsha Fudge, who is his congresswoman. At the time, she was chairwoman of the Congressional Black Caucus. She didn't even answer. But I'm telling you, a growing number of black people are beginning to realize in the inner city that illegal immigration, unbridled illegal immigration, is threatening their livelihood. And for the first time, I'm hearing conversation I never heard before. If the Democratic Party loses their monolithic black vote, which is 95%, down to maybe, if the Republicans just get 20-25% of them, these guys are toast at the national level.
It's true. If Mitt Romney had won 8% of the black vote, he wins the last election cycle. Mm-hmm.
And I mentioned the economy. The black economy has been decimated under Obama. You could not have hired somebody from the Klan to do what he's done. The net worth of blacks are down 20%. The so-called wealth gap between blacks and whites is at a 25-year high. The labor force participation rate, the percentage of blacks who are looking for work or who are working, is at a 40-year low. Black homeownership down, black equity down. I've never seen the like of it. And people vote for their pocketbook, as I said. So you vote pocketbook and you start thinking about the demise of the inner city jobs because of illegal immigration. You have an opening that the Republican Party has not had in decades.
Let's take some questions and answers. Sir, why don't you, we have got a mic right here. Why don't we have
sprint
people.
Sprint on up to the mic.
Yeah, sprint on up.
With your Nike shirt.
That's right.
Yeah, swoosh.
By the way, Larry, what you're saying is Trump is drawing 25% of the black vote in the latest polls.
Oh,
it's
amazing.
And people want to be wealthy. And the idea that he's not apologizing for his wealth, the way Mitt Romney did, appeals to people who don't have money.
Yeah.